Hey everybody and welcome back. Here we are again, new day, new lure. And what we're gonna do today is the Emerald Shiner. Very, very popular bait fish up here. And this is pretty sure you're gonna find a lot of times in the those little frozen, salty packs you get from Cabela's or Bass Pro or whatever it is. What we're gonna start with is just a little bit of transparent, brown iron oxide. Spray a little on the back. This is our base coat and we'll go from there. So all I really want from this brown is for this to ultimately be a little bit of veining behind the rest of the colors. So let's get some mesh. Wrap it around. Okay, we're going to load up some titanium white, turn the pressure way down, spray from a bit of a distance, back in the helping hands we go. Got a little bit of green gold. Just gonna do a light dusting. I have this little, you see that? Gill plate stencil. I'm just gonna hold it over top of the gill plate here while I just do that spray. I do want this green gold eventually on the head, but I want as little as that gill pattern as possible on the head. So there's the fewer layers I have to erase or cover up later, the better. Other side. Okay, now I didn't clean the airbrush in between the green gold and the gold. We'll still get a bit of that hue in there. It's a little stencil of mine. Now let's have a look after this dries. Metallics have a pretty sneaky way of sneaking underneath the stencil no matter what you do. So let's hope that took. We'll find out in a couple minutes. Moment of truth. Very satisfied. Okay, let's clean up that head and then we'll work on the rest. So here we have the other part of the stencil. Remember, always keep your negatives. Just place that around the head. More titanium white. Now for this part, you can white out as much or as little as you want. For example, I might keep some veining up here in like the temporal area. Now for the head, you just kind of repeat the same steps you did for the body. I'm still gonna cover up the head part just because I don't want to lose any of that detail. Back over with our metallic true gold. Get our metallic white, pull that in the brush, a few drops. And just spray a bit along the belly. Next to a bit of metallic silver. I'm just going to put just a little bit on the side here. Just nothing perfect. Just kind of blotch it around a little bit. Lighten up the mouth area. Okay, we have our shading gray. And we're just gonna kind of do like the lateral line. Got to get nice and close, I'm gonna have to move you too. Nothing fancy, just a little jig-jag motion. Okay, got some sepia. Just kind of tie in. Colors a little bit. A little thin. Not gonna go super defined on this one, just a little outline. Darken up that fin a little bit, just because it needs a little bit more contrast. Alright, I got some eyes here, but they're gonna need a little bit of work. So, sepia again. Right. Emerald shiner. Off to clear coat.
So looking back on the footage of all the painting, I noticed that the ring light that I used around the camera really made that shading gray stand out and look incredibly dark. As you can see, it's quite natural, it's quite blended in. So, if you managed to stick with me through the whole video up to this point, thank you so much, because, yeah, that video didn't really do this lure any justice. So there it is. Thanks so much, everyone. Please like, please subscribe, and, yeah, I appreciate all you that have already subscribed. Have a great night. Bye.